Hello, I'm Professor Tom Foltynie, Consultant Neurologist from University College London.
And I'm Camille Carroll, Associate Professor of Neurology at the University of Plymouth, and it's our pleasure to introduce you to the Edmund J. Safra Accelerating Clinical Trials in Parkinson's Disease Initiative, otherwise known as EJS ACT-PD.
EJS ACT-PD has been created with the intention of speeding up the discovery of a disease-modifying therapy in Parkinson's disease. What we mean by disease-modifying therapy is a treatment that can slow or stop the progression of the disease, which is something that is crucially awaited by the Parkinson's community.
Setting up and running clinical trials to assess possible disease-modifying therapies in Parkinson's can take a huge amount of time and resources. From first being identified to collating the appropriate safety data and demonstrating efficacy to progress through the different clinical phases. In the current clinical trial setup, each of these different phases are addressed using individual trials which are designed, funded, approved, and delivered in isolation, requiring a huge amount of time and resources before we can determine or not whether the treatment is effective. With Parkinson's disease being the fastest growing neurological condition in the world, improving the speed and efficiency of this process is something that urgently needs addressing.
The EJS ACT-PD initiative has been set up to revolutionise the way clinical trials in Parkinson's are currently run by using an innovative multi-arm, multi-stage or MAMS platform trial design. This type of design allows us to simultaneously test several different treatments against a single placebo arm. Interim analyses will assess whether the treatments appear to be effective. If they do, then we can continue recruitment to the arm until we have sufficient data to inform regulatory decisions. If a treatment doesn't seem to be effective, then we can drop this arm and replace it with a new candidate.
This adaptive approach addresses the inefficiencies of traditional clinical trial designs by removing the need to dismantle and rebuild multiple separate trials, making it both cost and time effective. It also means that less patients are required to be allocated to the placebo arm, and there is less administrative burden on sites for repeated trial setup and close down.
Of course, there are a number of challenges associated with designing a MAMS trial in Parkinson's disease. The EJS ACT-PD initiative includes members from all key stakeholders in Parkinson's disease who are collaborating to determine the best trial design, the appropriate outcome measures, the most promising treatments, and to assess the UK infrastructure. Most of all, to secure funding for this. Our PPIE members are involved in all of these decisions to ensure the patient perspective remains in the forefront of our design.
We are hoping to launch the trial in 2024 and are setting up a communications group and website so that stakeholders and other people interested can keep updated with our progress, get in touch to ask questions, and hopefully become involved. In the meantime, you can follow us on social media for regular updates.